Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, to MHS Gymnasium. It's January 10th, 2006. We're here for a non-league contest with the Clay Center Tigers. Take a little break from NCAA action. And we'll resume with that again Friday with, I believe, Russell coming to town. Ladies contest coming up. Two teams coming off victories, one-point victories. Clay Center beat Chapman by a point in overtime. And the Lady Lions beat Southeast of Saline by a game that could have gone to overtime pretty easy. Mike Perry and Dale Leach here, getting ready for tip-off. Little series history. The Lions, this is the 37th game. The Lady Lions lead 19-17 and have won the last two in a row. The last two games they've won pretty handily by 20 points or better.
We'd ask you to please rise, remove your caps if you have them, and direct your attention to the east end of the gymnasium where our nation's colors are hanging proudly. And once again, we'd ask that during the Star Spangled Banner tonight, you would direct your thoughts to those servicemen and women who are protecting our freedoms all around the world. And now tonight, our Star Spangled Banner will be played by Mr. Dennis Ball and Mr. Ryan Colquist, the brass duet.
Clay Center Lady Lions come in, or Tigers come in, pretty decent set of height, Mike. There's the 6-footer, the junior, Josie Walker.
That's got to be a sound dear to your heart, Dale, here.
Oh, yeah. Bone. You betcha.
Come right in there with the
I could just hear a second part in there. They've got 2 5-foot-10 girls, a sophomore and a senior.
See how many of the tall ones they start here.
Sorry about that thrill ride there, folks.
So far, we match up rather well, Dale.
Clay Center out of the NCKL League.
Shoemaker, Perry, Atwell. Allie Catron getting a second start in a row for John Darrow's Lady Lions.
Well, all their height is on the bench.
Sure is.
also a junior at 5'11", number 42, Jordan Paulson.
Yeah, we look a little bit, they don't match up quite as well with us.
Yeah. Somewhere, I thought I brought a pen or a pencil along here. There's a pen.
Our officials for tonight's contest, Mr. Byron Pollen, Mr. Rodney Pollen, and Mr. Brian Miller, our men in black and white.
Well, I'm glad we didn't have that foot of snow that heads south of Emporia.
Well, Kristen drove in it up in Kansas City, leaving Olathe this morning. Some sleet and ice, but yeah, south of there, good grief, they had 5, 6, 7 inches down there, didn't they?
As much as a foot in some places, what I read on the internet today. Jordan Crossan, leading scorer and rebounder for the Lions, will tip off here.
Ladies are setting up to control this tip. Not a very good toss-up by the referee, about 6 inches higher than Jordan's head. Baseline drive by Jared Shoemaker, and a dish-off to Allie Catron's knocked out of bounds by play center. Audrey Atwell throws the ball in from Minneapolis, back out on front, out on top to Jessa Perry, baseline drive. Audrey Atwell shot, stepping over the rim. Allie had a shot if she turned around. Play center in a zone, and they take the ball away as Jordan Crossan tries to get the ball in.
Shoot it.
Underneath. Minneapolis back into that man-to-man. Looked pretty good in their last game. Pretty effective defense for them. Shot by Clay Centers, no good. Jessa Perry on the move. Layup's up and in and count it. Undercut just a little bit at the end, and that basket's going to count. Crossover dribble to the left-hand side, and she went up strong with it.
Jessa Perry.
And she'll get the bonus shot. And she's been right on her free throws. I gave her a bad time about them, and I think she's hit three in a row, last ones I've seen anyway. 3-0 Minneapolis. And I thought, Dale, the last game, it was the defense that won that ball game for them.
Definitely. Same with the boys, too.
3 seconds!
Jared Shoemaker with the ball out on top. Eyes a three and a reach-in foul by Clay Center. And that's her second team foul in about the same amount of minutes. Perry will inbound the ball from Minneapolis. Out on top to Allie Catron now. Jessa sets the offense, looking at a 1-3-1 zone. Jared Shoemaker had the shot. There it is. That's a good look by Audra Atwell, just rimmed off, and Allie Catron cannot control the rebound. Minneapolis putting a little pressure on here. That's a double dribble. Good call.
Into the ball game.
Perry reached in and just tipped the ball just enough that Clay Center had to rearrange her dribble, and it's double. Shoemaker with the left-hand dribble across the court to the wing. Looking inside, and they're doubling up on Jordan. Perry's outside shot is short, but I thought, actually, it looked like somebody might have blocked it a little bit there, don't you think?
Might have been, but I don't understand that. She hadn't touched out of bounds.
I didn't think she did either. Play center breaks the press and cannot control the pass. 3-0 Minneapolis, 6 minutes left, first quarter. Crossover dribble by Audra Atwell. Nice look by Shoemaker, and the rebound's taken away by Clay Center's 5'10 post.
That would be Kelsey Payne, number 20.
Payne, pretty good sized gal, ripped that rebound away for the Lady Tigers. They're looking inside. Minneapolis still with a good man-to-man, and Megan Donovan comes over to try to stop that drive to the bucket, and she's whistled with her first foul.
13, Megan Donovan, her first personal foul. First team foul for
Megan. Came in for Allie Catron. I think they share that position pretty much all the way through the game. First one's up and in for Clay Center.
Checking into the game for the Lady Tigers.
Chantel Darrow replaces Jessa Perry.
And they hit both free throws, 3-2, Minneapolis.
Also checking in for Minneapolis. 5-2, sophomore, number 15.
Chantel with the ball on the wing.
3 seconds.
Back out on top, Chantel. There, we got an entry pass to Jordan. Nice little chippy by Jara Shoemaker, and she cannot knock it down.
It's 3-2. Lady Lions, 5 minutes to go in the quarter.
So far, kind of cold shooting by Lady Lions with two or three pretty good looks.
Blocked by Donovan.
Out of way.
Got a foul.
By Donovan. Foul number two. So she'll draw some carpet time here.
Donovan's.
No.
Second foul.
Leaving her in, taking, crossing out.
Number 41, co-captain Allie Catron.
Called on the floor, Minneapolis second team foul, both of them on Megan. Shot from the corner, rims off. Big rebound by Payne, and she's fouled by Allie Catron.
Rebound!
Good foul, though.
Good turnaround jumper there by Payne.
Foul is on number 41, Allie Catron.
Pretty aggressive on that offensive board.
Ripped that board away and turned around and shot it with authority.
Jeez. Kelsey pretty good rebounder. She showed that down on the other end.
It's all right. Get this one.
First free throw is up and rims off. Second one's the same way. Donovan with the big rebound for Minneapolis. Off to Chantel. Clay Center wanting to trap. And they throw it away. Play center guards with some pretty quick hands have picked her pocket a couple times now. Chantel with the ball back in the middle. Now, there we go. Shoemaker breaks the timeline for Minneapolis. Over to Chantel. She eyes a two. No good.
Still 3-2, 4:10 to go in the quarter.
Minneapolis still man-to-man. Play center looking for a cutter. Tipped out of bounds by Catron.
Substitution for Minneapolis, number 10.
Jessa Perry back in, and Audra Atwell will get a breather. We zone up on the inbound, and we go to sleep on the backside. Perry takes the ball away, and she's off to the races.
Payne rebounded her own shot. Perry took it away from her before she knew what was going on.
Shoemaker with a baseline drive tries to dish it off, and Clay Center's there to intercept the pass.
Another Perry steal.
Perry. Layup is good.
5-2, Lady Lions.
A little bit of quickness that Perry has brought to the floor has given us two baskets.
Totally irreplaceable.
It's a wonderful.
Yeah, that speed is always essential, but really sticks out if nobody else has it, you know, in a game like this.
Definite plus, and Jessa Perry has plenty of it. She's been keeping it fairly under control, too. At times, plays a little erratic, and there's Clay Center.
Yeah, they stepped out of bounds.
5-2, Minneapolis, 3:14 left, first quarter.
Better off right there.
Crossover dribble, Jessa. They cannot keep up with her coming up the court. She's looking inside, it's there, there we go.
Oh. Shoemaker rebound, she dribbles it in.
Nice move by Jara Shoemaker on the rebound. Nice trap by Minneapolis. Clay Center has that 6-foot girl in there now, you notice? Bank shots off.
She gets rebound up and in.
They're killing us on the offensive glass. Minneapolis not blocking out on defense. Clay Center able to get two putbacks off missed shots.
Well, the crowd's been telling this guy that call 3 seconds. He finally listened to him.
3-second call on Jordan Crossan. And their pass, their wing, cannot get a hand on it. Jess Perry is coming up the court. Out in the corner, Chantel looks at a three. Dribble drive, baseline, shots up. Rims off. Jordan with a hand on that rebound.
Wow. Another steal. It's 3 or 4 this quarter.
Jessa Perry. With a heck of a steal to save a bucket. And Shoemaker almost gets her pocket picked. Jordan.
Off.
If she'd use the backboard, I think it would be easier for her on those angled shots. It's just my opinion. Play center with the rebound. We missed 2 or 3 and they're close. Play center goes around our guard and goes all the way to the basket. Jara Shoemaker's there to stop the drive and it's foul and play center will shoot two.
Jara Shoemaker.
Lady Tigers first shot's up and rims off. Front rim.
That well replaces Jessa Perry and Seamers comes in for Catron.
For Minneapolis, number 2, Audra Atwell back in the lineup.
Second one rolls in. Minneapolis up 2.
And also for Minneapolis checking in.
7-5 the score.
Number 12, Krista Seamers.
Play center looking to trap and we're not having anything to do with it.
1-4.
It's a kind of a 1-3-1 with someone standing in front of Jordan Crossan at all times. Ball comes out, play center. With the rebound, and Jara Shoemaker tries to stop their progress and makes her second foul.
Her second personal foul.
Perry comes back in and...
I don't know if that's a sign of being just a little bit tired.
Checking in for the Lady Tigers, number 34-57.
Brittany Fulton comes in.
Right.
That's traveling.
Back in the game for Minneapolis, number 10, Jessa
Brittany
Perry.
Brittany Fulton in for Minneapolis.
The Lady Lions,
Jessa Perry back Brian in, and Audra Antwell. We'll go with the three-guard rotation here. Jordan Crossan off the glass. And she's missed 4 or 5 in there now.
Well, at least she got the rebound instead of Clay Center.
That's true. Offense got her own rebound and stick back just rimmed off.
Personal foul.
She'll shoot 2.
Jordan Crossan is at the line.
And that rolls in.
Box out, Black. Rebound it. Let's go. Rebound it.
So far, Minneapolis perfect on that free throw line.
Mm-hmm.
And I shouldn't have said anything. Second one rims off, and Clay Center claims the rebound. Jessa Perry ball hawking. And
she about got another steal. She got a turnover.
Turnover, that'll
just
work.
As good.
Alec Catron back in from Minneapolis, and Jordan Crossman will get probably a 30-second breather before the second quarter starts. Perry with the ball on the wing. Back over to Audra Antwell.
It's 8-5, Minneapolis.
There we go. Oop. Brittany Fulton with a nice look. And Jessa Perry claims that rebound on the backside. Audra Antwell looks at a three but doesn't take it. Perry does. That's short. Allie Catron with the rebound. Kicks it back out front to Audra Antwell. Seamers out at the buzzer. Coach did get their attention just in time. Pass to the wing. Seamers knew there's only half a second left. She let it rip, and it just rimmed off right at the buzzer. 8-5, Minneapolis at the end of the first quarter.
Each team is acting like it's 20 below zero outside, I tell you.
And we'll be back with second quarter action here in just a minute. Looks like Jordan Crossen will check back in.
Get open.
Play center with the possession arrow to start the second quarter here with the ball out on top. Ball inside to the big post.
Blocked by Crossen.
Good position by Jordan. Straight up and play center trips Audra Antwell from behind. No call.
Out of way. Rebound, rebound, rebound.
Point shot.
Rebound.
No good. And just Perry with the rebound and foul by Clay Center.
Fourth team foul.
11, Andrea Anderson.
The Lions have five.
Clay Center still willing to press. Three on one. We had numbers and we got all excited and took an extra step.
Up,
start with
up,
turnover Minneapolis, 8-5.
Out of way, take it.
Now they got the ball in deep to the post.
Move, 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 go help.
Minneapolis still in a man to man.
Take her, out of way.
Dribble drive, baseline, play center, shot goes up and over the rim, and Minneapolis with the big defensive board. A good job blocking out that time. Play center still in a 1-1-3 type zone. They're matching up on Jordan and fronting her everywhere she goes.
Nice drive to the basket there by Jessa Perry. Drew the foul.
Number 34, Kate Wright. That's her first personal foul and the fifth team foul at the line, Jessa Perry.
First shot's up and in.
Go, bumps out.
Substitution for Lady Tigers.
Cantel Darrow back in for Minneapolis and Megan Donovan. 6:45 left, first half. Second one's up and in. Jessa Perry with
three of the night
about
for her.
All our points.
That's three of the night for her, I think. Free throws.
Yeah.
Yeah. Crossen had one free throw. I know. I can't remember if anybody else had any points or not.
Play center trying to attack this man-to-man defense of Minneapolis. Looking for cutters. They have one every now and then. Not able to get the pass off though. Doing a good job picking underneath.
5 second call, ought to be.
Shot from the wing, no good. Chantel Darrow with the rebound. Holds up and gives the ball to Jared Shoemaker. She has to realize she is the point guard. She needs to just go ahead and bring the ball down. Quit worrying about making that pass. Teammates already gone on down. Play center throws the ball in. Half court. 6 minutes left, first half. Get the ball in deep, and there's Megan's third foul. Donovan with the hack as the entry pass goes in deep. Play center will play it in under their own basket. And Seamers comes in for Donovan.
10-5, Lady Lions. 5:58 to go in the half.
We zone up on that inbounds play. Play center not recognizing the zone. Shot by Clay Sanders, no good. Seamers with the rebound from Minneapolis. Shoemaker on the move down the lane. Shots up, rims off. Jordan Crossan with the rebound. Took her time with that shot. Off the glass and in.
Shoemaker had a bucket too earlier. She's one of them at points.
Yeah, she did. Clay Sanders throws the ball away. Boy, if I yelled at the kids like that, I think I'd have a headache.
Mm-hmm.
About 3 minutes into the game. 12-5 Minneapolis. Jess Perry with the ball. Right in the middle to Chantel Darrow. Down the lane she goes. Dishes off to Seamers. Had a good look. Jordan now over to Seamers. Travel.
Jordan does camp out in that lane a little bit.
Yeah, they wanted that call again, and they got a traveling call on Seamers.
Get open. Come back.
Jessica Perry with a good defense and steal. Tipped out of bounds. She does have quickness. 12-5 Minneapolis. Seamers with the foul as Clay Center goes all the way to the basket.
Let's go knock him in, use legs.
Yeah, I don't know if she's too short or not, but I would think one of the JUCOs would be interested in her.
Oh, yeah, I think so.
Are they?
I would think so.
Nope. I hadn't heard any recruiting news on her, but I would think there would be somebody.
Say Jordan?
No, Jessa.
She'll have to learn to dribble with the other hand a little bit better.
Yeah.
Handled the ball a little better, I think.
Well, she's improved so much from year to year in that area.
You are absolutely right. 12-6 Minneapolis. Clay Center made one of the two. Free throws. Chantel with the ball. Back in the corner. She eyes the shot. Just rims off. Jordan Crossan whistled with a foul.
Here, I thought she did a good job getting that ball.
It was straight up when they came down. She was over the back when that Payne girl from Clay Center, so strong, brought that ball down, and then she was over the back. 1-1. No good. Crossan with the board for Minneapolis. Over to Chantel. Well, back on the other side, Seamers now to Perry, shots up, gets her own rebound for a second.
They call Crossan again?
No, they better. Yeah, definitely Clay Center over the back that time. And we're shooting. Should be.
Yes, that should be a 1-1.
I guess that was just the sixth.
The board's wrong then. Oh, yeah. We've got eight. They've got six.
Audra Atwell. Shot is no good. Jordan with a great rebound. Cannot control the.
Great position there by Jordan.
Yeah. Oh.
I got her pocket picked again, didn't she?
They sent her with another offensive board. The ball away from Seamers. Her shot is up, rims off. Jessa Perry with the rebound. She's on the move. They cannot. There we go. Nice dish off to Otter Atwell. Up and in. Somebody called timeout just before Jessa Perry picked her pocket again.
Clay Center calls timeout.
Her coach saw it coming.
The Lady Lions are leading 14-6. That's one thing I was talking about coaches. I've just been reflecting on the last few days, how fortunate we are in Minneapolis to have such gentlemen and good examples coaching both teams, the girls and the boys. You know, we've had
I'll agree with you there.
The last two opponents the men have had, their coaches have been wild and constantly harping on the refs and not being good examples at all. I can't say much. The women's coaches for the opposing teams are pretty good, but tonight we got a women's coach that is
coaches in this school system
pretty much out of control.
Play center, a little trouble handling the ball. Brittany Fulton back in for Minneapolis. Allie Catron in. She stepped way out of bounds into the blue, didn't she?
Yeah, she did.
Number 10.
I could have seen that even without my reading glasses.
And she stepped out of bounds. My, she's fast. Ball on the wing, back baseline, Brittany Fulton. Audra Atwell, three-pointer. Oh, just rims off the back. Perry with the rebound. She rolls it out. Clay Center intercepts. They have a two-on-one. Fulton, late getting there, fouls Clay Center, and that basket's going to count.
It's 14-8.
Knock it in. Let's go. Use your legs.
Arch the ball. On number 20, Brittany Fulton.
Come on.
First personal.
Bonus shot. Good. Rattles it in. Good way to get it back to shoot it in, and Brittany Fulton does.
Finally, one bounced in.
Another blocking foul on Brittany Fulton. Trying to shut down the baseline, and Clay Center.
She moved too late, didn't she?
Double bonus.
She moved a little bit too late.
Foul is on number 20, Brittany Fulton, her second personal foul.
Clay Center will shoot too.
Clay Center, Andrea Anderson.
First one's no good.
Well, Clay Center hadn't hardly hit any free throws this evening, I don't think.
Not too many.
Well, we've got 10 fouls, so this could really be killing us here.
Second one looks short, just barely hit front rim. Chantel with the ball on the wing to Jessa Perry.
2:22 to go in the half.
Atwell.
16-9, Lady Lions.
Allie Catron, ball's inside to Jordan Crossan. Shots up, no good. Chantel battling for that rebound, tipped out of bounds, and it will be Clay Center ball.
Seamers comes in for Catron. 208, 16-9, Lady Lions.
Ball in close, Payne with a shot in the paint. Clay Center. It's good. Ball taken away from Audra Atwell. And it's 16-11. Now Chantel Darrow steals it back for Minneapolis. She's going coast to coast. It's up and in.
18-11.
Nice under look by Chantel as the defender went right on by. And Minneapolis guards putting on some steals tonight. And that's a good call. Travel. She turned and took two steps to the basket. Seamers was there, and she about ran right over. Minute 18 left. First half, Allie Catron back in for Minneapolis.
And Fulton.
Substitutions for Minneapolis. Number 41, Allie Catron. And number 20, Brittany Fulton.
We'll put Minneapolis in 1-1 if we are fouled. Allie Catron with the ball on baseline. Looking inside, and they can't get it in there. They're fronting Jordan. That rims in. A nice free throw by Audrey Antwell. Puts Minneapolis up by 11.
Got the shooter's bounce there, I guess, huh?
We were due. Sooner or later, we're going to start making them. But we got to block out and get the rebounds off of the offensive or defensive board.
20 is a good athlete.
Audrey Antwell with the ball in deep. Back outside. Perry's shot rims off. Jordan. And she'll shoot two. Offensive board by Jordan Crossan, and she will have two shots on that stick back. It just rammed off.
Jordan Crossan.
1-1 for the last 18.6 seconds, Mike.
First one's up and in.
Go, box up, box up.
Well, you never know.
Yeah.
That 1-1 might come in handy yet. And second one is up and in.
22-13, and we have hardly missed a free throw this half.
No.
And Clay Center has missed everything. It'd be a tied game if they're hitting their free throws.
2-on-2, Clay Center pulls it out. You gotta know Jessa Perry's coming up the floor. Tipped away, picked up by Audrey Antwell. 6 seconds, we have time. Her shot just rims off at the buzzer with Minneapolis leading by 9 here at the end of the first half, 22-19.
13. Near that close. Not near that close.
Good first half. Good defensively to hold Clay Center to 13 points, but I would venture to guess Minneapolis probably had 7 or 8 steals, maybe even 9, 10 steals. Mm-hmm.
That scored a 14-8 that period.
So.
And we'll be back with second half action here just shortly.
Well, Mike, we're getting close to almost the halfway point here, I think, on the season.
Already.
Yeah. One thing to start thinking about on down the line is Substate. And if you will have access to the internet and go to www.kansashoops.com. You can watch a website that Kenny Hendricks has been putting together for the girls and the boys, the 2A, tracking what teams are winning, what teams are losing, and what all the records are per substate. Looks like so far for the girls, there's one team to reckon with. And that would be Osborne. Of course, we'll be playing on their home floor if we make it that far. We're the next highest team in number of wins. At least it's been reported with our 3-3 record. So. On the boys' side, it looks like Smith Center and Plainville are the teams to watch, and Solomon also. Smith Center has a 6-2 record, Plainville 6-1. Minneapolis is a 5-2, and Solomon's also a 5-2 record.
Yeah, I was impressed with Solomon over at the Blue and Gold tournament. They are very athletic. They had a pretty good game with Halstead, I thought. They could have easily won the game early in that tournament, but as luck would have it, they lost one of their best players early in the, at the end of football season. That man was killed. That was their best ball player, so we didn't even see him.
I wasn't aware of that.
Man-to-man defense by Clay Center.
Is he out for the season or gonna be back? Any idea?
He's in a car accident.
Oh.
He's gone forever.
Oh, one of those
kinds
of things, huh?
Quick turnover by Minneapolis to Clay Center. Will attack man-to-man defense. Minneapolis is flying. Looks like Clay Center's coach has instructions what he would like to see as far as an offense. I'm sure that's part of it. Basket's up and in.
22-15.
See the ball!
Nice crossover dribble by Jarrah Shoemaker. Dishes off to Allie Catron. Left-hand dribble, and she's fouled. Goes all the way to the basket, just like she should. Uses the left hand, and she'll shoot two.
Foul is called number 22, Haley Carpenter, at the line, Jarrah.
Play center girls favoring Jarrah's right hand, and she has a devastating crossover dribble, and she can handle the ball with that left hand. She's got loose twice now in the paint. But she's just going to have to take that eight-footer because it's there. Second one's up and in. Two in a row by Jarrah Shoemaker, and Dale mentioned earlier, Minneapolis shooting the ball rather well from the free throw line. There's a steal almost by Jessa Perry. Play center looking inside, it's not there, now on the wing. Coach wants a little motion, play center. Rotates through. There's still nothing there. It's just good tight man-to-man by the Lady Lions. Ball on the wing. She's left-handed. She can go all the way to the rack. Jordan Crossan claims that rebound for Minneapolis. Now to Jarrah Shoemaker. She's not willing to be trapped. Now on the wing to Jessa Perry. And if you're quick enough to see that step, she traveled. She'll get it back right here. Nope.
Go fire!
There, she got it back. All the way in, layup is up and in. Jessa Perry with another steal. That cross court pass from Clay Center gives her time to take two steps, and she's got the ball. Now the good defense at the top of the circle.
26-15.
Play center with a good drive to the basket. Shot is up and missing. Minneapolis with the rebound. Now Jarrah Shoemaker in the paint, all the way to the basket. Layup is up and in. That's what she needs to do. She's open. She needs to go all the way and take that shot. It's a layup. 28-15, Minneapolis. Look at inside, she was there, and they cannot get her the pass. Down the wing.
Oh, she walked!
I would have to say so. Tipped by Jessa.
Nice block.
Nice block. Running the floor, Jordan Crossan, and she's tied up. That girl's very strong, number 20.
Yes, she is.
She claimed to have that rebound.
She's just a great athlete. She's got moves. She's got it in the head, too. She's very aggressive.
Yes, she is.
And number 21, Haley George.
Haley George in for Minneapolis. Baseline drive, play center. We got to watch them. There's a lot of left-handers on that team, and they take the baseline from us with the left hand. Play center looking inside. Now in the corner. Now they got it inside.
Blocking foul on Crossan.
The foul is charged to number 42, Jordan Crossan. Her second.
She wasn't going to get the shot off. Crossan called with a block. Blocking foul. And we zone up on the inbound.
In the ball game for the Lady Tigers, 5'6" sophomore, number 23.
Still in a 2-3 zone, Clay Center. Looking for a shot, it's not there. Haley George. Down the corner, Clay Center. Tipped away by Jordan. Crossan pulls up, eight-footer, rims off. Haley George with the rebound. Now in the corner, Chantel. Short. Clay Center on the move. Minneapolis shuts the door. Three-point attempt. Rims off. She gets her own rebound. That's up and in. Donovan back in for Minneapolis. Jarrah Shoemaker with the baseline drive. Back out front, Chantel. Bank shot by Haley George. She's got a nice shot.
And she used the glass. I like to see that.
I love it.
It's such an ally, that glass. It can be.
Pass goes over the head of Clay Center. Jarrah Shoemaker with the loose ball goes all the way in. Going to call that on the floor. Foul on Clay Center. Second team foul here in the second half. Minneapolis will play it in under her own bucket. 30-17. Haley George will throw the ball in for Minneapolis. I take that back. Krista Seamers came in to replace her, and she'll throw the ball in.
Krista McMahon. Number 24, Mara Page.
Perry George Seamers. At will.
Quick release by Haley George. No good. Seamers with the rebound. She's fouled.
Over the back by the 6 foot girl.
Excellent rebound by Krista Seamers on the offensive glass. Stick back. She's fouled. And she'll get two shots here.
Hope that some young lady get injured. It's like, is that a Perry girl?
First one's up and in.
No. Oh, that's the young Shoemaker girl.
Yeah, she rolled her ankle today in practice. Second one's up and in. Nice rotation on that shot by Krista Seamers. And two more free throws, Dale.
Well, that's a heck of a thing to have happen at the end of the season.
Jessa Perry picks a pocket at Clay Center, and she's fouled on her way to the basket. That's all they could do.
Wish she could have seen Audrey Atwell streaking the a basket on the other side all alone sooner.
It's the only negative when she's dribbling. She does not see the floor. Haley George with the ball out front. Now to Jessa Perry. Top the circle. And it's a zone. Clay Center back in that zone. Seamers, jump shot, good. 12-foot jumper by Krista Seamers right at the free throw line. It's down, the hatch. Minneapolis with a 17-point lead. And they throw it away.
2:15 to go in the third quarter. The Tigers have scored 4 points this quarter, Mike.
We've done well.
Yep. We scored 12.
Chantel with the ball, top of the circle, looks down the corner. Audra Atwell back to Seamers, around the other side to Jarrah Shoemaker. Seamers looks at that 12 footer again. She just hit one from there. Now Audra Atwell with the ball in the corner. Tipped as it goes across, and Seamers cannot hang on to it. Shoemaker steals the ball. Now a long pass to Jordan Cross, and she's fouled. I thought the ball went away a little bit.
Audra Atwell and Crossan both went for it.
They had Crossan on the arm, and she went to the basket for that shot. She'll shoot two.
That's her second personal foul at the line for Minneapolis, Jordan Crossan.
They finally missed one. Can't brag on them anymore.
Ashe Shoemaker will have to get that ankle healed up by Thursday. Jordan, second one, rims in. 35-17. Haley George back in for Minneapolis.
George.
Clay Center beats the press.
Whoa.
And it's stolen away by Jarrah Shoemaker.
Two steals by Jarrah here in the last minute.
Now over to Haley, down the corner to Chantel. Looks at a three, it's not there. Haley, now out to Krista Seamers. They are double teaming Jordan, aren't they?
Yep.
They still get it in there. Over to Haley, she had a shot. And they're over the back of Jordan, I believe. She's taking a beating in there, isn't she, Dale?
Six fouls on the Tigers this quarter.
Kara Shoemaker shot from the corner. It's good, it's a long two. And Minneapolis is ahead 20 points.
Drive.
Minneapolis now in that 2-3 zone. Pardomar. Shot by Clay Center is up and in. And they get Haley George with push off.
I've seen worse not called.
Foul is charged to number 21, Haley George. Her first personal foul.
35 seconds left. Clay Center throws the ball away. 37-19, Minneapolis with just a few ticks here left in this third quarter. Get the ball in to Jarrah Shoemaker. Clay Center still wanting to press. We break the timeline. Now over to Shoemaker. And Krista Seamer, she's looking underneath. Jump shot by...
Great work by Jordan Crossan.
Clay Center girl laying on the floor, and Jordan put the shot up as she was falling backwards. Shoemaker with another steal. 6 seconds left. She's got time. Haley Jordan with a shot. 1 second left. This is the ball. Ricocheted out to Haley George. Presence of mind. 30, or just a second left on the clock. Hammers down a 12-footer at the buzzer. And Minneapolis in command here in this ball game, 41-19, with a big third quarter, Dale. Defense, the steals, doing a real good job rebounding.
Outscored them 19-6.
Wow.
That's a very good quarter.
That's a good quarter. And we'll be back with the fourth quarter here shortly.
Up by 22 points.
Wonderful.
Number 13, Megan Donovan. Number 10, Jessica Perry. Number 2, Audra Atwell.
Clay Center back into man-to-man. Tipped away by Clay Center. Minneapolis will get the ball. Allie Catron back in from Minneapolis. So is Megan Donovan. Haley George, baseline drive back out on the wing to Audra Atwell. Back out on top to Perry. Over to George. Atwell. Perry looks at a three. She's looking inside. Zone defense. Looks like by Clay Center. Give and go by. Wow.
That poor girl. There's not a referee in the land that doesn't know she fouls, I think.
That would be your fourth foul in about 4 minutes playing time. Tonight, anyway. Clay Center gets the ball in. Minneapolis, man-to-man, picking up full court. Haley George. Defense now, Megan Donovan tipped away by Jessup Perry, and Clay Center recovers. 7 minutes left in this contest. Minneapolis still man-to-man defense.
Great Catron. Defense, Allie Catron stepped out of the pick.
Clay Center took a step as she ran into her.
22 Shoemaker and number 42
turnover.
Crossing.
Clay Center in Minneapolis will play the ball in. Ball in to Jessup Perry, and up the court she comes. 22 of Clay Center tried to shut the door on her as she
Here I come. Stop me if you can.
Foul is on number 22, Haley.
I think we're 1-1.
Seventh team foul.
At the line for Minneapolis, Jessa Perry.
Well, this will be the third impressive victory the Lions had over the Tigers in a row.
Jessa Perry is 5 of 5 from the free throw line tonight. That's 6 of 6. She's got that free throw stroke all squared away.
Remember when it was great if she could just hit the rim?
Oh, yeah. There's times she would miss the rim.
Yep.
Walk. Change pivot feet down low. The play center Payne girl is called for traveling. And we get the ball in. Audrey Antwell with the ball up the court. She comes. Now down to Shoemaker. Baseline. Jump shot. Rims off. And Clay Center with the rebound. Good shot by Clay Center. No good. Perry with the rebound. And up the floor she comes. Katrin, free throw. No good. And that's a foul on Jess Perry.
Yeah, I'd say she fouled her. Probably could have got Allie Katrin before her, but
right.
Checking in for Minneapolis. Number 12, Krista Seamers.
That's what's amazing. All the steals and activity she caused, she only has one foul.
Yeah.
In the early fourth quarter.
A lot of havoc, didn't she?
Yeah.
Minneapolis looking to trap. Shoemaker almost intercepted pass, and all she could do is stick an arm out as Clay Center goes to the basket. It'll be a two-shot foul for Clay Center.
Jarrah
Shoemaker's third foul.
Fifth team foul.
Chantel and Seamers back in from Minneapolis. And that little girl's got a nice stroke.
Yep. Andrea Anderson, she'll be back in next year. She's a junior.
They get their own rebound off the missed foul shot. 43-20. And Jordan Crossan will
get a reach in foul.
With her fourth.
The foul is on number 42, third. Jordan Crossan, her third personal.
We zone up on the inbound play here at Clay Center. Ball in, closely guarded by Seamers. Now out front. 2-3 zone by Minneapolis. Pass down low, Clay Center has a jump shot.
Krista Seamers, I think, with the foul. No.
Push off by Clay Center. And Seamers will shoot, you're right. The foul was on Clay Center. Payne with her third foul.
Go box out.
5:30 left. Fourth quarter. She has nice arch on that shot. It goes up and gives it a good chance of going in. Second one is good. She's 4-4 from the free throw line. I've never seen Minneapolis shoot free throws like this before.
Especially the girls.
I think we've only missed a couple all night long, and we shot a bunch. Trapping defense by Minneapolis. Clay Center. Pass too hot. Not be handled.
A 25-point lead, 5:20 to go.
Kept away by Clay Center. And Megan Donovan jumps in there.
Like I said, I would just see her get that fifth foul right now. But nope.
Possession arrow to Clay Center. Still looking to trap Minneapolis. Not slacked off a bit. Shot by Clay Center is no good. And Chantel with rebound and push by Clay Center. Reach in foul. And we're in 1-1.
fouls on number 21, Danae Rothfuss, her second personal foul. At the line for Minneapolis.
Chantel goes to the line shooting a 1-1. We'll see if we can keep that hot free throw shooting going. It's good. Hits the front end of that 1-1. And she'll get the second. It rolls, rims out. And that might be the only third free throw we've missed all night. Clay Center with the ball in the paint, cannot get the shot off. Jordan Crossen still there. Three-point attempt is up and in.
Oh, can't do that, girls.
I didn't see that.
Well, Jessa, Megan Donovan was out of bounds. Jessa Perry's inbounds. Jessa threw it to her. Megan wanted her to have it, so she jumped out of bounds and threw it back into Jessa.
Clay Center with shot from the outside and tie up. Possession arrow to Minneapolis, and we throw the ball in. Perry with the ball. Up the court she comes. Entry pass, Jordan Crossen. Oh. Backside rebound by Jara Shoemaker, and she is hacked. On the putback, she'll shoot two.
Foul is charged to number 21, Danae Rothfuss.
Notice this.
That's her third personal foul. At the line.
Notice this.
First one's up and in.
Substitutions for Minneapolis.
Haley George back in for Minneapolis.
George.
Chantel Darrow.
47-23, 4:17 to go.
Second one's up and in. Minneapolis just flat knocking down free throws tonight. Which is good. That's why we're hit by 25. Clay Center with a shot from the outside.
Megan Donovan gets foul number five. Or Crossen, one of the two. Crossen.
Hey, you're right,
Donovan.
The first time.
Yep. Foul is on number 13, Megan Donovan.
Well, she played a little longer that time.
That was a nice stretch there. She stayed in for
two or three minutes.
She's aggressive. I like aggressive ball player, and she's definitely.
Melanie Catron comes in as replacement. Haley George is in. Oh, and another one. Don't any know the name at all, Mike.
Her last name is Briggs. It's Monty Briggs.
Kayla Briggs.
Kayla, yeah.
5'4" sophomore. Yeah.
I knew that.
Number 23, Cassidy Kramer. Number 34, Kate Wright. And number
Kayla Briggs with the ball on the wing, looking inside. Out Shoemaker. Man-to-man defense by Clay Center. Kayla with the ball. Now back on top. Melanie Catron in.
Melanie Catron.
George back over to Briggs. Now inside to Jordan. That's up and in. Nice move by Jordan Crossen. Chiefs starting to find the range now. 50-24. Clay Center with a shot from the outside and Crossen with the big board from Minneapolis. George bringing the ball up court. Now on the wing to Kayla Briggs. Shoemaker, top of the circle. Now on the wing, Haley George inside to Jordan Crossen. Reach-in foul by Clay Center.
Fouls on number 44, Joseph.
They've quit fronting Jordan, and so the Clay Center player is all alone guarding her. So the entry pass is there, and it's going in there.
50-24 with 3:01 to go in the game.
Free throws up and in. Chantel back in for Minneapolis. Jared Shoemaker with a good ball game. Haley George comes out.
Minneapolis, Fulton.
Brittany Fulton back in for Minneapolis.
Allie Catherine going to come in too.
Free throws up and in.
Also for the Lady and Georgia Crossland takes a well-deserved rest. 52-24.
Good ball game. Started out a little slow, a little cold early, but Jordan made up for it here in the second half. Outside shot, Clay Center is good. It's a long two. 52-26, Brittany Fulton with the ball. Now Chantel clears the timeline for the Lady Lions. Brittany with the ball. Good hustle by Chantel to get the tie up as that pass was tipped away.
Substitution for Clay Center, number 13, Crystal Marks.
Entry pass to Clay Center. Goes in and comes back out to the girl that just checked in, and ball goes through her hands and out of bounds. 2 minutes, 20 seconds left in this contest. Brittany Fulton over to Melanie Catherine. Good ball movement by Minneapolis. Back on the wing to Chantel. Entry pass into Allie Catherine's tipped away.
She turned the other way. Ooh. Melanie Catherine draws the foul.
She met her partway down the lane in the paint, and
the foul is charged in the
like she
four.
Had ball, must have had some.
Didn't quite have position, I guess.
At the line for the Lady Tigers.
And that's Melanie Catherine's first foul. First foul, free throw up and in by Clay Center, and that's one of the few that they've made.
Cassidy Kramer, a sophomore. I don't think she's been in much tonight.
Second one's.
She fouls over the back.
It's a good example right there. Brittany Fulton closes off the shooter after she shoots that free throw. Somebody's got to get in front of that shooter and has an excellent job of blocking out. And over the back. And Fulton will get two free throws right here. Minute 49 left. First one is short. If it's anything like the one Cameron had the other night, this one will be a swisher.
Mm-hmm.
Second one's up and good.
Well, not a swisher, but it went in. We'll take it.
Now the game for Clay Center.
Minneapolis only missed four free throws all night long. The rest of them have been down the hatch. Minute 39 left. They got the ball inside to the big girl. Now on the wing, baseline, jump shot. No good, Brittany Fulton with another rebound from Minneapolis. And Allie Catron's outlet pass bounces off the 20s. Brittany with a shot from the field, no good. A little quick on the shot. No one in position for a rebound. Clay Center looking inside. Now back out on top, driving the paint. They can't get a shot off. Tendency is always to try and grab it after it's been tipped, and it goes out of bounds, and it's awarded to Minneapolis. Haley George back in for Minneapolis.
Well, Melanie Catron get abused in there.
I guess it's her turn. Jordan was for three quarters. Now it's her turn. She'll go to the free throw line. They're in the double bonus.
At the line for Minneapolis, Melanie.
He'll have two shots. Trout rims it.
Yeah.
second one's up and in. 54-27. Minneapolis with a comfortable lead.
Is that what you call it?
We call it 27-point lead. And we step out of bounds. 29 seconds. She's looking. Chantel. Bank shot from 20 feet. And Clay Center tracks down that loose ball. Top of the key. Now on the wing. She's got a shot. Hits up. Off. And that's the ball game. Final score, Minneapolis Lady Lions 54, Clay Center 27. It's pretty good outing for Big Blue.
Nice, impressive win. Two wins in a row.
And that concludes our girls game here.
Increases their record to 4-3 on the season. And another good chance for a win coming up with Russell coming in the gym next Friday.
Pretty impressive game tonight. A little bit slow starting out in the first quarter. After that, we took control of this ball game and never gave it up. Minneapolis with a comfortable 27-point lead at the end of this thing. Nice job. We did especially nice job. The defensive pressure we've been putting on man-to-man defense lately has been very impressive, creating numerous turnovers, and I don't know how many steals we had. I bet we had at least 10 or 12. 12 steals gives you another look at the basket. So
I would bet Clay Center had 20 to 25 turnovers easily.
I think you're probably right. We created many of them for Clay Center. And then from the free throw line, Minneapolis probably
scorched the Nets.
Missed four or five all night long.
If that many, they scorched the Nets. It was an impressive outing. We led all the way through the game in the first quarter, 8-5. Outscored them 14-8 in the second quarter. And the third quarter is a big outing, 19-6. And in the third quarter, 13-8 for a 54-27 win.
JV boys over in the grade school gym just claimed a 59-52 victory over Clay Center over there. And Jamal Townsend had 19 points.
Great. Great.
Great.
Fantastic.
Well, about 20 minutes, we'll let.
And you might need that.
Hope you enjoyed this game. Brought to you by the MHS Linebackers here on Galaxy Cablevision, Channel 37, MCTV. Dale Leach and Mike Perry signing off. We'll be back for the boys game shortly.